there. My name is Nathan. Thank you, Reece and Richard, for coming along to speak to us today. Richard, how did you find out about the story?
It was New Year's Day 2010. I read it in a newspaper and I was fascinated by the story. I really connected to it as somebody that had been struggling for years as a young filmmaker to want to tell stories through film. And I just really connected to this young man who used dance as protest and struggled for as long as he did. And I didn't realize how lucky we were in this part of the world and how we take our artistic freedoms for granted. And I didn't realize how important the voice of an artist can be and how much for young people it's very important.
I didn't realize how expressive dance could be, and you brought in Akram Khan to do the choreography. Did Afshin help with the dances as well?
Obviously you didn't want to journey away too much from what he had done, because obviously that defeats the object of telling his story. But at the same time, we needed a kind of a technical prowess to sort of show through in the film, because Afshin was fundamentally self-taught. He didn't have classical training as a dancer. So in a way, I had to become so technically aware with the dance so that we could dial it back. You know, we could still produce the quality that the film needed.
Richard, it's a story about freedom of expression. Have you had any positive feedback from the Iranian public?
There are thousands of people from Iran that are saying, thank you for telling our story. Thank you for putting a human face to us. Thank you for showing how positive things are over here rather than just the negativity all the time.
Quite rewarding then.
Yeah. No, it's amazing. What's been fantastic is that, you know, we told the story about the oppression of freedom of expression in Iran, but what's been amazing is learning that oppression isn't just an exclusive membership of the Iranian regime, that people from all over the world feel oppression in their own ways and it's relative to their own lives.
Well, Reece, Afshin is a character who is viewed as controversial by one group of people, yet is admired by another. What was it like to portray him?
He just fascinated me. He's very naive on a lot of levels, in that his pursuits are quite simplistic. You know, he just wants freedom of expression.
Did you spend a lot of time with Afshin to prepare for the role?
There was a balance, because I think if you spend too much time, it becomes an imitation. So I wanted to know the important points that we had to honour, and then also we had to have a certain distance. So went to Paris, obviously talked extensively with him, Skyped with him, didn't we, and spoke, you know, and don't forget we had like hours and hours and hours of interview footage to reference as well. We cooked gourmet sabzi, we cooked Iranian food, listened to Iranian music, read Rumi, you know, poetry, and we had an Iranian advisor on set, so we were very conscious of honouring the Iranian culture.
After watching Desert Dancer, what message do you hope that people take away?
I think just to really identify what it is that you're passionate about and what you're willing to do in order to pursue your kind of passions in life, I think.
You know, guys, I've been thinking, I want to start a dance group.
An underground dance company.
It's different.
You get caught dancing, you go to prison.
It would be cool if people left the movie and was like, okay, what am I willing to fight for? You know, what matters to me fundamentally?
It's nice to have a piece of cinema out there that young people can look at and can be inspired by to really work hard and you know, live your reality to attain your dream.
Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Brilliant.